All right, guys, we are keeping it nice and quiet tonight. It's pretty cold outside. Keep the door closed. I'm gonna do my Hal Dex. Now, I talk a lot, so if you're not into that, just go find another video. I've always, my whole life, called it Halidex with an A. And just in the last week, I finally learned, and I'm trying to retrain my brain, that it's Haldex, and you don't put an A in the middle. So, Haldex service here. I ordered from Euro because my normal place did not have this in stock. So, I do have two O-rings, two screws for replacement screws for the pump. I mean, yeah, maybe. And you have your drain and your fill, all new. As well as the oil, if you have been following a little bit, you know that I was talking about, I had some oil, maybe I should use it. I used it on my GTI axle, I said. And then everybody said, no, it's way different oil. Then my kit came in, same exact part number. And then it was just a miscommunication of words. I meant that I used it in my LSD, and people thought I meant different when I said axle, so it was a different type of fluid. Obviously, I know gear fluid, super thick and the worst smelling. So it turns out I did have actually the right fluid, but this is brand new, stamped and sealed, ready to go. So just a quick backstory. Why am I even doing this? The car has 11,000 miles or so. I just got it like a month ago, 6 weeks ago. So I don't know any of the history on it, which is why I do a lot of these things, so I can be sure that it's good. Damn it. All right. Yeah. So I'm not going to level it yet. You can see, of course, I do have some nice safety jack stands under there too for those pesky ramps, even though they've always been solid, but you never know. All it takes is one, right? So we're going to get under there, we're going to get a light, and I'm going to remove those plugs to start with and see what we can do here. Quick sidebar, before I was just about to start the work, I remember I didn't have my pump yet, so I had to go through my funnel bucket over there, and I have both kinds anyway. So these are like $5 on Amazon or something. Always use them for my axle jobs and stuff like that. Looks like this one will be fine. I also have a nice long cord on it. Now I may need to put a smaller adapter on that hose. We'll see. That fill hole looks pretty tiny. All right. So first, I'm going to show you the two plugs. Not like I'm any genius. I've been watching a lot of videos for this exact thing all week. So I have it all memorized. So your fill plug is that little one on the side. I should maybe brush this off first. It's going to be dusting the whole time with this powder oxidation. And your drain is right here. The inward one right here. That's your longer one. So I'm going to first take off this one. Let me get you a decent angle first. Oh, that is a sick angle. That is killer. Oh, you may be looking over there, but anyway, it's close. It's close. First, make sure. Oh man, that sucks. I need a shorter. Wow. Okay. Not that big a deal. Let me find another tool. All right, guys. So I don't make you sit through the, 10 minutes it took me to find the right stuff. But first I tried one of these with a regular thicker socket. And now I'm down to a quarter inch. And it fits good. It fits perfectly in here. So we go right up here. And I already popped it loose, so I don't lie. Let's see. That's tightened. I was getting nervous when it, just because I tried some shorter stuff like an Allen wrench first when I wasn't thinking right, and it just wasn't budging whatsoever, and I thought maybe it's all jammed up, but as soon as I got a proper tool in there, it just broke loose like a, not a baby's butt, but like something really like the knife through butter. All right, finished taking out the fill plug. I don't expect anything to spill, but who knows. Almost have it out. Here we go. I didn't think there'd be anything. Hell, I mean, I'll be half concerned that there wasn't even enough fluid in there, but I'm not going to start pushing my finger and trying to feel it and push this dust in there, you know. Put the old one over here in front of my light, which you cannot see. All right. Whew. Now it's exciting to get this one off here. I believe I have it here. Oh, did I not tell you the other size? Sorry. This is an 8, so this would be a metric 8. hexate, I should say. Now, I don't know if I can fit a socket in there. I'm gonna have to go a 1 inch maybe to get back a little bit because it's too close to the edge. My ratchet probably won't work. All right, so if this goes in here and I make sure that it's in a good bit, first off, I don't think, yeah, that's not gonna work there. Would a 1 inch get me there? Super close, maybe. Oh, yes. Oh my God, 1 inch extension. Let's see, no, that's wrong. Okay. Make sure it's seated, because I worried like it didn't seat all the way. Yeah, I should push it on my car, right? Oh, that's much, much easier than I thought. Never mind, that was enough. And again, the Torx are like inch pounds or something. I don't even know what they are. I will go look them up because, I mean, obviously I want to do a half decent job. So let's hang out here for a minute. This is a long bolt. Might take a while to get out. Poison dust. I know, I should be wearing glasses. You're right. But, you know. You know, I'll get my glasses. Hang on, guys. Don't leave. Boom. All right. We're going to see the drop. And just in case oil gets on my arm, not like it's going to gush. And it's at an angle now, which would actually help it drain, honestly. Some people do the angle just for the drain on some of the stuff I read. Okay, this is coming out. I'm gonna pull it slow so I can really get a nice gander. Okay, it's sort of goldeny, not too bad. I'm still just holding it up a little bit. I forgot something I was gonna tell you guys. After I ran the reset adapt and the pump thing you all know about, but I also ran the reset adaptation on this stuff. And today on the way home, I was kind of trying to try it out a bit. And I swear it already felt proper and better. It seemed to just go quicker. It was weird. I think the adaptation probably solved it, but I certainly want to make sure this, look at the screen. Although this car only has 11,000 miles, it's 3 years old. It's a 2018, 2020, 2021. So that's probably even with the time frame to check the screen. Regardless, especially the oil too. Let me get out of the oil. Oh, I slowed it down too much. So what I'm saying is I think it's already fixed, and now I just want to have super fresh fluid in there. I'm doing it all proper, the best I can. I think I'm following all the rules, even going to use new bolts. So no harm in it, just, you know, the money spent on parts you may or may not have needed. But I definitely want to inspect this pump once because of that strange behavior it was giving on our launches when I was hanging out with BJP. He's probably sitting under his car right now, and actually he's probably working. He works a lot. I mean, I do too, actually. Worked all day. 10 minutes after I get home, I'm under my car, loving my life. All right, I'm gonna stop the camera for a bit and maybe let this thing drink properly, let it have a proper. Wanted you guys to have a really good view of the color. I found the perfect for my Torx 30 for the pump. And no, I'm not going to disconnect the wires. Nice and easy again. Let me go get the one in back on the other side. 1 inch extension is perfect, it looks like. I could have gone maybe a 2 inch, maybe a little easier. Yeah, I might go it. I got it. It's fine, but a longer extension will help, yeah. Use a 2 next time or something. All new bolts, that's cool. I don't usually do that. So if it hadn't come in a kit, I might not have. So I am glad that I got all these cool new bolts to use. It's because of the oxidation and rust surface stuff, I mean. There, I'm getting it.
I might have to knock it loose, you know, sometimes, and I don't want it to fall out and yank on the cord like I saw in someone else's video and it dropped like a foot and got caught by the cord. But, oh, actually, I take that back. That was his one he was replacing anyway. Oh, this is, yeah, not bad, not bad. I can just work it, slowly work it out. Yeah, we recording? That's cool. Check it out. Okay. That's the first O-ring. See it? Springy? And then I gotta push past the second O-ring spot. There we go. Come on, baby. Oh, is it the... Let me... Wait, shoot. That's my fault. I think the cord is holding it on the other side. I think I literally didn't look enough. There may be one harness that I gotta undo so I can take this out properly. Let me go check it. All right, I got it, guys. I didn't disconnect any harnesses. I'm just being very gentle with it. So now we can really have a nice look at this stuff. And yeah, it doesn't look too bad at all. A little bit though, a little bit. Let me try and get you the right angles here to properly see what's going on. That's not very good. Sort of like that, yeah, not too much. I may not even change the O-rings, honestly. Since I'm here, I might as well. I get what you're saying, I paid for them. But tons of DIY people didn't do it and have done it 5 times, never had a leak, etc. But I'd almost like think the other way around, save them for spares and don't disturb what is here, which was never leaking. That's what I'm gonna do. Is that a, yeah, it's just liquid. I thought it was a nick in the O-ring. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna reuse these and not disturb them, which can also start causing problems, and gently put that back in. After, you know, cleaning this, I'll probably unscrew it just for fun so we can take a really close look. And then I'll very carefully put it back in. I'm gonna hold it aside when I have 2 hands, and I'm gonna wipe all the junk out inside here. You can see some of it maybe. No, you can't. Not really. It's always in the way. The freaking camera's always in the way. But I saw some dark stuff in there too. Maybe I'll show you that when I get a chance. Can you see that dirt piled up in there? See that dirt? Super angle. I got everything oily for you guys, including my GoPro. I'm showing you the inside of my pump housing that I am gonna clean. I'll probably spray out with electric spray. Hell, it'll be the quickest and easiest. And then I found this sweet pond spot up here where this just hangs out. No harnesses have been disconnected whatsoever. Easy access to unscrew that screen. Let's go, guys. All right, inspection time. I haven't cleaned this yet, and it might go, we know GoPro doesn't focus well, so you have some pieces right there. This side is real nice. Look at that. Oh, there you go. Try and get some light to focus on it. Look at that junk, guys. Yeah, well worth it. Shoot, yeah, why not? So anyway, it's not clogged. Maybe 10% decrease probably would not have caused any issues for me if we're honest. But anybody with more than that, definitely slow down your reaction of your rear wheels and cause problems. They wouldn't clamp tight enough. All right, guys, I'm using electronic cleaner
even though it's four times as expensive as brake cleaner, but it is safer, just for everything really. So, I mean, yeah, it's not good for my hands, of course. Oh yeah, it's gonna look brand new. I'll go from the other side too, of course. I'll waste a whole can, screw it. And let me get, oh yeah, there's even, I thought that was rubber gasket stuff in there, but it's actually dirt. Wow. Oh my God, that thing is mint. Ooh, I found a little speck inside the filter. Sweet, I got that out. Look at that. Hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about, guys. I also cleaned the back of this thing right here, the big cylinder. I didn't notice, but it was also very dirty and messy at the bottom, especially that porthole. So I didn't spray in it to not push anything up. I just wiped some of the just dirt and gunk that was on the bottom plate there, and it wiped pretty clean. So it looks all right. The hole looks good too. So now I guess I could keep it rolling, but you're not going to see much. Ooh, even out the secret peephole. Even clean that out. Yeah, there's oil coming out of it. Okay. Yeah, I mean, the pump up, that's the pump hole. I made sure it was clear. That's even awesomer. Is that a word? Hell yeah. What's up, bros? Okay. Reposition the light a little bit higher. There you go. Does that look pretty clean? I'm gonna, oh, is my freaking camera blurry again too? Maybe I got it covered in, oh, bros. Oh, maybe I'm all right. I don't know. All the splatter might have like destroyed my GoPro. Looks like the stains came off the body. Hopefully it doesn't destroy my screen, but the screen is removable, so we're all right. All right, let me take a look for myself and then we'll continue getting this thing done. So another cool thing about that little filter is it can only go one way. Man, I got that thing, a brand new one couldn't have looked any better. It only fits one way. The holes will fit in two ways, but you have a big bolt there, so that obviously makes you know. And the slot that we saw, you saw it, it goes over this here, so this just slides in. Find your pins, snug it up, super easy, super special. Oh, careful, careful. Danger, danger. Look at her, isn't she gorgeous? Is that my kids will continue to the conservation of wildlife when I'm long gone. I miss you, Steve. Now, I shouldn't even put a ratchet on this. I may do a little tension, a little tension. Do I have it? I have it. Obviously, yes, I'm paying attention. Obviously, these are like pin bolts. Maybe I shouldn't even use that. Because it's still, I'd rather do it by hand, honestly. It's probably more than tight enough by hand even there. It just tightened up. I'm not going to overdo it. It's about as tight as I can go by hand. I guess it is kind of important that maybe I should give it a tiny blip with the ratchet, because we are talking about a screen, and what if it falls off? So I kind of rethought that as I was sitting here. Little snug. See, I have no pressure on the ratchet. Little thumb action. There, very, very nice. Little pressure on the thumb. I'm not gonna rip it out. Perfect. All right. I've cleaned everything. Okay, first step done. Let me get my new screws. Where are they? Are these the ones we're talking about? Yeah, yeah. All right, yeah, the other two are still there. My OCD had me make sure. All right. Okay. Gently rock it. And some people did talk about a millimeter gap that the bolts could pull in. Not the best idea, probably. I'm gonna massage it a little bit, and then we'll see where we get.
Okay, I just got that all the way in fully by hand, although I did need two hands, and I very gently just gave it a little right here, and it just seated perfectly all the way in. So I think we are all good on that. So now we can actually see these bolts better from this side. I think I was on the other side when I took them out. Now you can actually see what I'm doing. Men becoming boys, boys becoming men. Oh, come on, baby. God dang it. I don't even know if it's going in. I'm gonna have to like probably put down the camera and just, I need to have feel for these to get them started. Yeah, actually that's going in. Okay, wasn't sure, but I do have torque specs on these. Let me get that out for you in a minute. So hang tight. You almost got your moment of opportunity. Man, dang, is that freaking clamp leaking pretty bad? That sucks, whatever. Is this, this might be my new clamp too. Oh, damn, what a rip. I mean, it's, it was OEM. See, I don't know, whatever. Best I could do, it's, maybe it's too tight. I don't know, it's super tight. Anyway, back to business. All right, guys, the best pick I can really give you is that ground shot. So 9.5 Newton meter for the pump bolts, 9.5. Believe it or not, this wrench goes down to like 3 Newton meters or whatever. So it's actually a decent range for this. And we'll just see if it gets sketchy or if it gets tight. That should like be a one thing. Is that it? No, not yet, but it's close. I thought that little creak was the actual torque. Beautiful. Look at that. Perfect. I'm not going to overturn it past that click. Beautiful. I want the best chance to salvage these existing O-rings. Remember, I did not change the pump O-rings. I'm sure a few people will say, oh, mistake. I also read about people that said, don't disturb what ain't leaking. So there's two sides to the coin, guys. Here we go for number two. Oh, beautiful, man. Beautiful. All right, getting there. We haven't even started the fill yet. That's like, that's the pain in the butt right there is the fill. So I'm just doing the basic stuff right now. All right, drain plug is next. And then we're ready to finish up. Drain plug, 32 Newton meters, 32. All right, we got the pump torqued. We got the drain torqued. Now we got to go over to the other side and get that fill pumping and see where we get. All right, let's get this pump going. The goodie box. Exposing my beautiful Hose Technique silicone hose collection from the old days. Yeah, it's gonna be a good fit right in there. Get a couple tie wraps, just be just fine. Beautiful. There's a good look. Okay. Test the angle. Yep. I had this extension because for the exact same bottles, it's just perfect to reach the bottom. Sure. It's all clean. Reasonably clean rag. Yeah. Not going to put dirt into it. Okay. Actually, just for the hell of it, wipe it down. Might as well. All right. Lock this baby in. Gotta get you a higher shot. There you go. You're probably gonna like ask what I'm doing about temp. Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fill it all the way, pump it up, and let it drain out of the top hole. I gotta actually move this up so I don't get false drains, you know? Oh, it's not even tight enough. Dang it. All right, guys. Nothing a fuel injection hose clamp can't fix. Get out of your way here. Drink, my baby. What I'm saying is, I'm going to have it go till it drops here. I still need to pump up the front of the car. I'm just kind of getting started. And actually, a lot of people go till it spills, run it for a minute,
to get it, you know, a little circulating maybe. And then they'll kind of get it level and do the fill test. So I'm starting with just pumping up. Pump up the jam. Pump it up. The potty's growing here. Do I see something? No. Sometimes it's remnants. If you go too quick, you get false positives. Let me just keep the pump nice and steady. In. Out. In. Out. In. Oh, out. Dang, this is taking a lot. All right, I guess, yeah, that's true. It takes 0.8 liter. This is probably a 1 liter bottle, so most of the dang bottle, and then I'll have some extra. Here it comes. Plus, yeah, definitely. I don't want to waste it either. That's enough for now. That's close. And I still got, feels like a half bottle, so I got a good amount. You know, I at least got a third of a bottle left to top up and adjust and get it warm. You know, of course, I am going to follow that process. Don't worry about all that. 20 to 40 C or something. I'm going to double check it. I forget what it is. That's not bad. That's a good start for the fluid. All right, I'm going to pump in a little more. The car's just about level, closest I can get here. And I just want to make sure that it was completely pumped. So I'll just put in just the tip. Just the tip, and I'll pump nice and slow. Because that could have been a little rush or a little wave like an ocean, and it could have been a false overflow. It didn't drip for as long as I thought it might if it was full. So there, let me take that out and take a look. Probably start gushing. Okay, that's definitely a good start. I still have, what do we got here? A quarter of a bottle plus my spare bottle. Not that I think I'm gonna need it, but you also have a nice little thing here, a holder. This can be kind of messy. One thing I'm gonna do here, I'm going to put in the old fill plug for now. And when I do my final torques, I'll use the new one. All right, now we don't have sun, but you can sure see a whole lot of story in this anyway. Look at that. Woo. Doesn't look fantastic. There's bits and stuff like, I mean, little dirt, whatever. That's the same stuff I was scraping out of, you know, the housing, little bits. Let me try and find a... Okay, that bit kind of disintegrated as I pressed it. I was just seeing if there's anything like... That looks big over there. Nope. It mushed into nothing. So... Yeah, I know I shouldn't touch this. Wow. Worth changing, I think so. All right, guys, you get the whole story when you come to Last Human's Garage. So we got a vag calm. Ooh, my fogs are on, my secret fog switch. Nobody saw, I don't think anybody saw. All right, so we want 20 to 40 C. We're close, shoot, 15, 16. Awesome. What I don't know, and I'll tell you I don't know, I'm just going to start the car as is, and I'm going to have to go off ramps for the level test. The ramps don't let me go down low enough to make it even. I want to do it right, so I will be getting rid of the ramps after. So actually, I'm not getting under it again. I'm going to pull off the ramps in a minute. It's going up, guys. I've only been running for like a minute or two. So you do not need to do anything except sit here and idle and park. Awesome. You were probably yelling at me, guys, when I was trying to get it warmed up just sitting there. You have to, you know, move your tires. You have to roll your rear wheels to get stuff to just move in there and maybe get warm. So I'm just slowly taking it around the block. I'm super easy. You also can get all four wheels off the ground if you want. And I'm not sure if that'll work, actually. I don't know if the rears would spin freely off the ground, but anyway, I'm just going around the block once or twice, get that temp where it needs to be, and then we'll come back. I've only gained a degree or two. I don't really want to engage the rear wheels by flooring it or anything, you know, right now, because I haven't done it. It looks like it is climbing. It's a little slow, but I don't think I need to do anything except drive it a few more minutes here. This car drives so silent when you want it to. All right, guys, the jacks are ready. I just turned it off and we're still at 23, so we're good. So I got jack stands in the rear, jacks in the front. I'm only gonna be getting under the rear. And we'll get set up again and get this done. Yeah, what the hell? I'll put on an extra jack stand just for the couple guys that always like to chirp up. Now we got double. Holy crap, that's a stiff chassis. Wow. Okay, it's even. Double jack stands, both on the rear. Let's get under there. All right, far less room than before to fit under here. Let me take out this drill or fill. And first off, see if it drips or not. Might not. Okay, we're low. Excellent. I'm putting the old screw in front of the lights. Nothing up my sleeves. Presto. Again. Rookie. Watch me pull a massacre out of my hat. All right. The slow pump is gonna commence again. Oh, I think I just put my hair in some oil. That's cool. I got my new shiny one. Get my tools ready. All right, we're pumping and pumping. Blow the house down. Pump, pump, blow the house down. Now this fluid isn't quite the same temp, but you know, that's why you have a range. Here it comes, okay. A full drip yet? No, it's just teasing me. Let me do one more pump and we'll see if it starts gushing. Hope you can see the fill. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, I'm just right about at the top. Here it comes. I'd like a little quicker drip that I can then decide when I'm gonna stop letting it drip. One more and I should get steady. That's what I'm talking about right there. Yep. Perfect. Wow, that's perfect. All right. Get this cleaned up real quick. My arms, my shoulders. The car is perfectly level. This is awesome. So I was a little low on my test drive. You know, that's interesting. I guess I was also angled poorly to probably have it drain out quicker. I was on a ramp, a rake, back up in the air. That's probably what one of the problems was with getting an accurate first fill. So yeah, I pumped in like pretty much all the rest of the bottle. There might be a fifth or sixth of a bottle left, but yeah, that was the whole point. All right, this is the new screw. I'll do it halfway, clean up the drip, and then go the full way. Just like that. Clean all the oil off the socket so I can turn it with my fingers. Ugh. Or actually, screw it. It's so easy at first. Use your finger, why not? I'll be right back. Let me get this oil out of your way, guys. And so a simple manual turn, whatever, 8 foot-pounds. Absolutely perfect. That's more than tight enough. All right, we are done with the fill. Still off the ground, as you can see. Just about equally off the ground everywhere. So, job done. Oh, you know what? I am gonna run the 2 VAGCOM adaptation stuff, but I'm not gonna show you that. Look at the previous video. I had a couple clips of that, but I'm gonna run that now, especially because everything's fresh and it's unclogged and sprayed out. Maybe that pressure, maybe that voltage will learn a little higher and stronger because it's not clogged anymore. It's not seeing fluid blocking up, not flowing as quick, and it lowers that voltage because it just can't get the pressure. So hopefully that screen lets the fluid flow faster. Lock those clutches. Dynamite. You guys, for the first time ever, I got finished correctly. Oh, it disappeared. I got finished correctly on the pump motor for the first time ever. And yeah, I listened to it squeak 5 times, like, and I was like, uh-oh. But I think it was maybe bleeding air, that's part of the pump thing, is with this oil change, make sure you bleed out any air for the passages and stuff like that.
All right, let's do our adaptation now that the car is turned off, the engine is off. I gotta remember how to do this. Oh, basic settings actually. Not adaptation like you'd think.
Resetting of all adaptation values, go. And this is usually instant. The ignition is on, of course, or VADCOM wouldn't be able to talk. Resetting is not reversible. They always send you the scare message. I did it yesterday. My car was running awesome. Finish correctly right away. Both the tasks are done. That concludes what I call a Halidex. Now, I'll take all kinds of tips on how to do it easier next time, save myself headaches, sure. Maybe some guy will say, I could have run it and drive right here. Homie don't really like to mess with that. I don't want to be just running my wheels and have something slip, crash the car into the wall. You know, I'd rather just take it around the lake a few times at like 10, 15 miles an hour. I know I didn't hurt anything. It was low anyway. It wasn't overfilled. So yeah, all I can do now is drive it a while and I'll tell you how it all worked out. Thanks for hanging out at Last Human's Garage. I think this turned into a long video. Last clip, if you hung out this long, you get to see the difference in the fluids, which is killer. Here you go, guys. Check that out. Isn't that incredible? That's a big difference, isn't it?